fell straight into your arms like a drum.
Everyone, I'm Harry, welcome to my channel. Today we're going to do another How to Sound Like video, so we're going to try and get the tones on Cocoon by Catfish and the Bottlemen. So I should say I managed to find a multi-track of this, so the only things that you're hearing on the original recording are the drums, bass and the vocals. All the guitar parts I muted and recorded my own in. So I'm doing this because Catfish have been requested quite a lot on my channel, and this is probably one of their most interesting songs to replicate because it has some really cool pedals and effects used for like the lead lines and then the bass overdrive tone. So before we get started, if you like this How to Sound Like video at any point, please leave a like, comment and subscribe, hit the little bell notification for me as well. It really does help me out a lot, and that way you won't miss out on any of my future uploads. There's going to be gear affiliate links down in the description to every piece of gear I used in this video and to record my videos. These do help support the channel out further, so I'd really appreciate it if you go and check that out. Okay, so the first thing we need to get covered is the bass overdrive tone that is used on both of the guitars, and it's quite a low to medium gain overdrive tone, pretty much just a standard indie rock overdrive tone. So the pedal that I was using for that was the Lowrider by SUV Pedals. This is a really killer low gain overdrive pedal that has a couple of little things in it that makes it more tweakable and suits different guitars as a result, and I actually use these controls quite a lot to get closer to the original tone. I actually recently did a full demo of the Lowrider by SUV Pedals, so if you'd like to see that, there'd be a link up in the cards, in the description, and pinned in the comments. So for the lead part on one of the riffing tracks, I was using this Matmull S Classic for some strat tones, and then for the other rhythm track that Van McCann plays all the way through, I was using my Matmull T Classic for some teletones. The amp I was running through today is my Cornell Romani Pro, which is kind of like a tweed style amp, but version on the Blackface territory as well. And then that was being recorded by the Lewitt MTP440 dynamic microphone, which is kind of like an SM57 with a little bit more bass. The only thing to note is on the pedal, there's two toggle switches. The Lowrider switch in the bottom position has the least amount of bass and mid frequencies, and then as you move it up, it gets more and more accentuated. And then the Air Ride, if you have it in the up position, adds a little bit more presence and a little bit more gain. So I had the Air Ride up for the strat just to get a little bit more gain going on, and then I had the Lowrider in the middle position just to fatten up the bridge pickup a little bit. So if I show you what the S Classic sounds like going straight into the Romani Pro, and then I'll kick on the Lowrider for the overdrive tones that I was using for the strat rhythm part, just so you can hear what difference the pedal is making as well. So there you'll see what it was doing to the bass tone. Now, for the little lead line in the verse, where it's like... There's two other pedals that I use to achieve this. There's a very slight, slow, very subtle phaser sound going on. So for that, I was using the Lillian Phaser by Walrus Audio. I had it in the four stage mode and with settings like this. And then there's actually a shimmer verb as well. So it's like a reverb, but then it pitch shifts up and has some really high octave stuff going on. So for that, I was using the Collider by Source Audio. The Collider is a killer reverb and delay in one. It has all the classic reverbs and delays that you'd ever need, and it got us really close to the original that I heard on this recording. So the shimmer reverb settings on the Source Audio Collider for the little verse lead parts look like this. And then for those parts, I actually had the Air Ride switch on the Lowrider back in the downwards position. It was a little bit cleaner with a little less gain. So just the Lowrider by itself sounds like this. Then with the Lillian Phaser kicked on. And then with the shimmer verb kicked on as well. So I use them exact same settings for the low part that comes in on the verse as well, where it's like... The only other thing to mention was for some of the other lead lines, I was actually using the plate reverb in the Source Audio Collider with settings like this. And then for the big solo, I had the Source Audio Collider in the plate reverb again, but just with a higher mix. So the first part we're going to look at is Van McCann's rhythm part with the cap on the third fret with the Telecaster. So this was just with the Lowrider by SUV pedals. So really simple, it's all just about how hard you're actually hitting the guitar to get a little bit more breakup. And then we had a tiny bit of plate reverb from the Source Audio Collider as well with settings like this. So I pulled Van McCann's rhythm track isolated from the intro song. You'll see the settings of the Lowrider on screen as well. And the only thing to note is that we had a tiny bit of plate reverb from the Source Audio Collider. Okay, so now we're going to look at Bibi's parts with the Strat for the rhythm parts first. So I was using the Lowrider by SUV pedals again. We have the Lowrider switch in the middle just to fatten up the bridge pickup a little bit, and then the Air Ride in the top position just to give us a little bit more gain and presence. And then again, we had a tiny bit of plate reverb from the Source Audio Collider with settings like this. So I'll pull the Strat rhythm part isolated from the intro song. You'll see the settings of the SUV pedals Lowrider on screen as well. And the only thing to note is you've got a tiny bit of plate reverb from the Source Audio Collider. Okay, so now we're going to pull out the main verse lead lines where we've got the and the lower part that comes in as well. So the only thing to note is on the Lowrider pedal, I just had the Air Ride switch back in the downwards position just to get it to clean up a bit and have a little bit less gain. And then we had a tiny bit of phaser coming in from the Lillian phaser by Walrus Audio with settings like this. And then we have the shimmer verb coming from the Source Audio Collider with settings like this. So I'll pull those little lead verse parts out. There's an intro song isolated so you can see and hear exactly what's going on. Again, you'll see the settings of the Lowrider on screen. The only thing to note is we had a tiny bit of phasing going on from the Lillian phaser and a shimmer verb from Source Audio Collider. Okay, so the next thing that we're going to look at is in the chorus, there's like this little faint overdub part where it sounds like on lead guitar where it's like... So for that, I was using the same settings as the lead part on the Lowrider pedal. So we have the Air Ride switch in the downwards position. And then we just add a tiny bit of plate reverb again coming from the Source Audio Collider. So I'll quickly pull that track isolated. It's a really short bit, but you'll hear and see exactly what's going on. You see the settings of the Lowrider on screen. And the only other thing to note is that we add a tiny bit of plate reverb from the Source Audio Collider. Okay, so the last part that we're going to look at is the big lead solo. So for that, on the Lowrider pedal, I just had the Air Ride back up into the topwards position to get a little bit more gain and presence going on. And then we have the Source Audio Collider providing a little bit of plate reverb, but I have the mix quite high this time because that's what it sounds like on the original recording. So I pull that lead line isolated from the intro song so you can see and hear exactly what's going on. You'll see the settings of the Lowrider pedal on screen as well. And just note that we had a bit of plate reverb coming from the Source Audio Collider with a tiny bit higher mix. So there we have it. That was a look how to get the times on Cocoon by Catfish and the Bottlemen. This was a really fun one to nail, and this is probably one of the few Catfish songs that I actually really, really like. They do have some good songs, but I'm not a massive fan of all their stuff. Having the SUV pedals Lowrider with its little toggle switches made it so flexible to tailor to get these classic indie rock times with a Strat and a Tele. And then we have the Walrus Audio Lillian Phaser just to get that really subtle phasing movement on the little verse lead lines. And then the Source Audio Collider providing the shimmer reverb on those verse lead lines and the plate reverb on the chords and all the other parts. So let me know down in the comments how close you thought I got to the original song and any future How to Sound Like videos you'd like to see me do. If you like that How to Sound Like video, please leave a like, comment and subscribe, and hit the little bell notification for me as well. It really does help me out a lot, and that way you won't miss out on any of my future uploads. There's going to be gear affiliate links down in the description to every piece of gear I used in this video and to record my videos. These do help support the channel out further, so I'd really appreciate if you go and check them out. Other than that, go onto my channel, check out some of my playlists. I have plenty more lessons, covers, gear demos, How to Sound Like videos, and anything guitar related. As always, I've been Harry, and thanks for watching.